The new year has started. With this, many new career aspirations will also blossom. So likewise, like most of the people will be considering to pick up new IT role. If you are watching this video, I'm sure that you fall into one of the three categories. One is like you are fresher and you want to know which direction or which career path you should pick up. Number two, if you are already working on some technology or tool in the IT field, but you want to upskill yourself and land into a different IT career path. So number three, you belong to a non-IT background and you are working in some different field and you want to switch to IT field and you want to pick up some new career. So do let me know in the comment section which category you belong to. Usually picking up a career comes with different aspects like what kind of a job you want to do and what kind of a person you are and what you enjoy like doing most and what you hate most, the work pressure and the nature of the work. So all these points comes in, and also importantly the salary offered for the position. So all these aspects comes into picture when you are deciding to pick up a career. So considering all these facts and considering the market demand, the salary offered and skills wise in which we see the future is there. So based on these, so I have prepared a 7 job list that you can consider picking up in 2023. Let's roll the intro. Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're gonna talk about top 7 IT careers that you should consider in 2023. So before getting into the video, if you are new here, I am Revanth and I'm working as a cloud DevOps and data engineer. So I'll be creating content on these topics. So if you are of that interest, kindly consider subscribing to this channel. So without any further delay, let's jump into the video. So the first job in the list is DevOps engineer. The reason why I kept DevOps engineering in the first position is due to its market demand. So as you see, the market demand for this role is really high, but whereas the skilled engineers who is available in the market is very low. So the HR and talent acquisition people are really trying hard to find these DevOps positions to fill. So if you are considering to pick up a new IT skill or new IT job if you are trying to apply, so definitely you can consider DevOps. One more thing is, it's not like a 9-to-5 job. Like it may cause like on-call shifts and so you may be expected to work on weekends as well. So when there is tight deployments going around, and also in some companies they are also having these rotational shifts and 24/7 per support. So this kind of an environment, so consider this as well. Number two in the list, data engineer. So what does these guys do? So these guys will collect data from various sources, bring it into a centralized data lake or data warehouse, and then cater the needs of the business. I mean the whole organization. So the people from the marketing team, sales team, data analysts or data scientists, even the management team, whatever the data set they require, so they will point out those requests to the data team, and the data engineer will be working on curating the data set and catering the needs of the team or the organization. This role is very crucial because like whatever the decision has to be made by data scientists, the decisions will be based on the data that is actually being provided by the data engineers. So this role is highly in demand, and you need to learn a lot of skills like Hadoop, Spark, SQL, NoSQL, Airflow, DBT, Snowflake, Cloud, Shell Scripting, Python, Scala. So it's a never ending list. So consider picking up at least some 5 to 7 skills and get good understanding and go in depth on these topics and start giving the interview, then definitely you will land into a very fruitful career. So now moving on to the next one. So number three in the list is data scientist or ML engineers. A is the sexiest job title in the 20th century. So that is so true so far. So 2020 or 2021 or 22, during this period, especially the AI and ML engineers and their career field like has grown exponentially, and the trend seems to continue in the upcoming years as well. So if you are picking up a new career, you can consider this AI and ML engineers role. For this role, you not only need to have some technical expertise like machine learning models or Python and R or SQL. Not only this, apart from this, you need to know some mathematical and like probability and statistics knowledge as well. So if you are having these skills or if you are interested to pick up these skills, then definitely you can consider picking up this career. Number four in the list, full stack developers. So gone are the days where the companies were hiring multiple persons like a middleware engineer, front-end engineer, back-end engineer, because nowadays the companies hire a single person who can handle front-end, middleware and back-end, and also the database systems as well. So one engineer who does like end-to-end from user experience point of view in the front-end until data storage in the back-end, and serving the needs using the middleware and back-end. So if you can pick up all these skills like front-end React.js and Angular and middleware, and also the back-end like database systems, Node.js, these kind of back-end engineering systems, then you can land up in a really good role and which is highly paying, and also the market demand for this role is really high and it's really hard to find a skilled and experienced full stack engineer. So definitely you should try this. Number five in the list, cybersecurity engineer or cybersecurity specialist. I would say cybersecurity specialist role is evergreen because the demand and necessity for this role, the people in this role is growing day to day. For example, like in 2020s, this career was like fruitful. Like most of the people were adapting to this networking and how to create a secure systems and all. So you may be already hearing that. So with the growth of this public and private cloud, clouds nowadays. So it is important for the organizations to secure their cloud systems, secure their data that is being stored in database systems, and also to prevent the attacks from the hackers. So this role is very much crucial for an organization. So if you are considering to pick up one career that has to be fruitful, that has to be evergreen forever, then you should consider picking up this cloud security specialist role. And also you have to be continuously learning, because like every day, even yesterday I saw in news that China has built a system that can crack encryption, any kind of encryption. So when there is such a massive growth in the technology space, then definitely some bad guys are going to target and make money out of it. So definitely there's a huge need for cybersecurity engineers in this world. So definitely you can pick up this role if you are of that interest. So number six, blockchain developer. So this is one area that has seen massive growth. So both in terms of like user adoption or like technology adoption, I would say like with the evolution of Web3 and DApps, blockchain development field is like growing exponentially year by year and month by month. So if you want to niche down in one particular area, like instead of a generalist, if you want to be on one specific niche, then you can pick up this blockchain developer role. This role requires skills like good understanding on blockchain and on how it works, so how to efficiently write a smart contract, and also you need to pick up some new programming language like Solidity, TypeScript, and you need to be aware of Node.js and peer-to-peer connection and networking between these nodes. So all these understanding you should have to pick up this role. And also you should be continuously learning, because like every day some new things are coming up, new technology, new tools are evolving in this space. So definitely every day you should spend some time learning the new stuff. Especially this field is highly rewarding, like you can get ransom packages. And also one more good advantage about this field is you can work remotely, because most of the crypto firms or most of the DApps firms I am seeing in the market, mostly they are offering work from home, and you can work from anywhere in the world. So that means like you can sit in India and you can work for an US company or an Dubai company. So this is another advantage of picking up this career. Last but not the least, cloud engineer. So what does this cloud engineer do? So these cloud engineers are the guys who own the infrastructure space of the company which is running on the cloud. So they will take care of like creating IAM users, providing access and deleting the access, and like creating a new VPC, I mean network connection between like how you want to design, so only to allow access within the company or outside the world. All these parameters they will be deciding and they'll be working on. Eventually, once you land up into a data engineering career, and so after some years of experience, you can turn into a cloud architect, deciding like how your cloud infra should look like. So you can decide how the whole company's cloud infra should be, and you can also like architect the software design practices as well. And also this role has slight correlation between the DevOps engineers and cloud engineers, because like so most of the skills that is required by a cloud engineer is also being required by a DevOps engineer, so it's vice versa. So the skills are interchangeable. So the companies hire a DevOps engineer and end up doing the cloud stuff. Both careers are different actually. DevOps engineer supports on the deployment of the applications or what are the pipelines that other developers build, whereas the cloud engineer's primary focus is on building up and setting up and managing the cloud infrastructure. With this, we came to the end of the video. So I hope this video helped you to niche down to one particular role and pick up your right career for your career aspirations. Or if you have some doubts, clarifications, or some suggestions or recommendations required, please do let me know in the comment section. I will go to each and every comment and reply to you. So see you in the next video. Until then, signing off, your Revanth. Bye bye.